Some people have trouble figuring out where the Central Coast is, but people who live and work up here know exactly where it is. It's that stretch of exposed coastline between the northern end of Vancouver Island and the southern tip of Haida Gwaii, and it's an amazing part of planet Earth. The Central Coast has traditionally been a hard place to do science because there's nothing up here in the way of infrastructure to support the work. But that's all changed now. We've established a research station at Hacai on Calvert Island, right in the middle of the Central Coast. We now have several established science programs at Hacai, but until now we've had nothing on the rugged outer shores, on that landscape of archipelagos, reefs, channels, bays and beaches that stretches north from Hacai. It's the world of rocky shores, kelp forests and sea otters. So I'm thrilled to be starting work with the Solomon Lab this summer, embarking on a major initiative on a landscape that so epitomizes the Central Coast we know so well and love so much.
Forests are one of the most productive ecosystems on our planet, home to a remarkable diversity of marine life. These liquid forests provide a plethora of resources and drive ecosystem processes that coastal people have relied on for millennia. Yet these underwater forests are highly susceptible to overgrazing by sea urchins, universally the most important temperate reef herbivore capable of controlling the distribution, diversity, and productivity of entire kelp forest ecosystems. Any force that alters their numbers can bring these rich ecosystems to tipping points that, when crossed, can fundamentally restructure marine processes and resources. For example, sea urchin numbers are heavily influenced by the presence of sea otters. So when the historic fur trade eliminated these predators from most of North America's high latitude coastlines, this caused a cascade of effects that rippled across ecosystems, driving rocky reefs to switch from kelp forests to urchin barrens. Today, along the outer shores of BC's Central Coast, sea otters are recovering and expanding their range. What remains unclear is when, how, and to what degree these kelp forest tipping points will occur. This summer, we've begun to explore these questions, establishing study sites from the McMullen Island Group all the way down to South Calvert Island. At these sites, we're measuring the variation in sea otter foraging behavior, rocky reef fish assemblages, and subtidal invertebrates and kelp communities. There is so much to explore, and this is just the beginning.
Thank you. Don't you dare.